This couple adopted a girl. Then they noticed that she was very different from the photos provided by the agency. Like all happy couples, Chris and Lena always dreamed of having a family life. However, to their misfortune, they didn't have kids. After waiting for many long years, they finally decided to opt for a different route to turn their dream into a reality. While searching, they came across an adoption agency to find a lovely little girl waiting for her family. The first time they saw Maria, they knew it was her who could complete their family, but they were reluctant to adopt Maria because of an issue. If you have not done so already, please subscribe to our channel and click that notification bell to get inspired by these real-life stories every day. Now, back to the story. Maria's age was the issue that made Chris and Lena reluctant to adopt her. She was a 6-year-old girl. They'd originally planned to adopt a baby with whom they could fulfill their dream of making a family from scratch. So it was complicated for them to adopt a girl who was already 6 years old. They didn't want to let go of their wish to adopt a baby. However, as soon as they sensed a green signal from the adoption agency, they couldn't hold themselves back from going through with the adoption. Maria was a sweet and lovely girl looking out for the family of her dreams. Although Chris and Lena were reluctant to adopt a 6-year-old, Maria's innocent face made them change their mind in an instant, and they decided to bring Maria home. Maria was adorable as a doll. Chris and Lena couldn't even have decided otherwise. They intended to be better than other adoptive parents, so they asked the agency to speed up the adoption procedure. Chris and Lena were delighted to see their dream of a beautiful family turning out to be a reality. They always dreamed of having a family with a child in a frame, and it was certainly hard for them to wait any longer. The adoption agency was also efficient enough to complete the adoption process in just a few weeks. Chris and Lena already felt emotionally attached to Maria, and even during those few weeks, they couldn't keep themselves from staying in touch with Maria through voice and video calls. The adoption agency also looked very eager to process Maria's adoption, and so they sped up the procedure. The director was personally involved in expediting Maria's adoption process, as he didn't want to give Chris and Lena enough time to change their minds. Before he chose to adopt Maria, Chris was told that the adoption process was a very lengthy one. But in this case, the process was swift enough. It only took a month or less for the adoption papers to be finalized in the couple's name. This speedy procedure might be questionable, but Chris and Lena were too impatient to bother with it all. Chris and Lena already knew many couples who postponed adoption because of its lengthy and complicated procedures that took months or even years. But in their case, it took less than a month, and they couldn't have been happier. It took only 3 weeks to complete the entire procedure, and they were told the date when they could finally take little Maria home. Chris and Lena were so excited and overwhelmed to welcome Maria to their home. They designed a whole new bedroom customized to her choice. Chris and Lena counted down the days to meet their girl at last. Finally came the day when they were going to welcome Maria as an official part of their family. The ecstatic couple couldn't help their excitement, and they left for the airport way earlier than their flights. They reached the airport earlier, and the flight was a little delayed too. So they had to wait for a few hours, but it was definitely worth it. As the flight landed, a group of girls stepped out of the plane. The couple kept looking for their girl to make an appearance. The couple would raise Maria's name card whenever they saw any little girl coming out of the plane. But every girl passed them by, leaving them more and more excited for their adopted girl. After a few minutes of waiting, they saw a gray-haired woman with a little girl coming out of the baggage area. Little Maria rushed towards the couple when she saw her name sign card in Chris's hands. The couple grabbed Maria in their arms and hugged her tightly. The old lady with her was her caretaker from the orphanage and had come along to make sure Maria met her new parents safely. The gray-haired lady was there to sign some final papers needed for adoption. Only after signing those papers could they take Maria with them. The lady handed over a pile of documents to Chris containing identity information for Maria. The euphoric couple invited the lady to visit their home, but she was in a hurry. She refused their invitation because of her scheduled return flight. She barely stayed for an hour or two before she left for Brazil on the next one. The couple didn't notice her rush. The couple knew that Maria came from a region different from their culture, so she wasn't very familiar with their culture or even their language. When they met Maria, they knew that she couldn't speak English, and they were already prepared for that. They drove back to their home to show Maria her new home, especially her decorated room. It took them half an hour to drive back home from the airport, and they tried to communicate with Maria. Poor timid Maria remained silent all the way and didn't speak a word of English. Chris and Lena were prepared for the communication issues to come. They'd started taking Portuguese lessons soon after they got the adoption confirmation, so they were prepared to welcome Maria to her new home. Saludo! On their way back home, they were confident that their hard-learned Portuguese lessons and Maria's little effort to learn English would overcome the language barrier between them. However, Maria came off to be more jet-lagged, so she chose not to respond. The couple quickly gave Maria a home tour as soon as they reached home. They made her walk through the newly decorated room, toys, and her soft bed with a pair of pink cushions. Maria was super tired and too tired to talk much, so she requested to rest for a while. Lena wanted to chat with Chris about something she noticed in Maria, so Maria's fatigue turned out to be a good sign for them. Lena left Maria in her bedroom and wanted to share with Chris what she might have noticed earlier. The couple was happy, finally having completed their family. Their girl was with them in their home, and it was the most satisfying feeling they'd ever had. They were barely interested in thinking about anything else. The couple only had Maria's photos when they decided to adopt her, and now they had Maria with them physically. That's when Lena noticed Maria was different from the girl in the pictures. Chris also couldn't differ from her view. Something was wrong, they felt. The agency might have prepared Maria for a photo shoot and forwarded those photos to the couple. The couple rationalized themselves, thinking the agency must have touched the images up a bit to make Maria look prettier and expedite the adoption process. Lena felt Maria was very different from the photos provided by the agency. When she hugged her and grabbed her in her arms, she felt something other than girlish. It made Lena upset, and Chris felt the same way. Chris and Lena were different from other adoptive parents who were concerned about physical appearance and beauty while adopting babies. They weren't interested in physical beauty, but they only wanted to complete their family with a little new member. Besides, Lena also knew that, like some other countries, Brazil was notorious for human trafficking. For these reasons, physical appearance did matter a lot. But adoption's something different from buying, and that doesn't require such modifications. The couple was so excited about having Maria with them that they didn't want to think about anything other than Maria's adoption. They felt something was wrong, and they just wanted to know why the agency manipulated Maria's photos before sending them. Chris, being a computer expert, decided to reverse the photo manipulation to find the fact. Also, he wanted to find the use of Maria's photos if there was any outside of it. He tried Google searching and other advanced reverse engineering techniques but couldn't find anything. In the end, he decided to use the dark web. Initially, Chris felt he was only overthinking and nothing was fishy about Maria. Then he found Maria's photo on some Brazilian website along with other children. However, the description was unclear and he thought it to be about some children waiting for adoption. Nothing stood out in those photos, but Chris's instinct forced him to search more. He searched on the dark web, but it looked like ordinary orphan houses' photos in adoption lists. But then he found something disturbing. While searching the dark web, the couple found a link that was different from the previous one. It was Maria's photo with a list of other children. Though it was in English, the captions were from a Brazilian writer and small. The couple was surprised to see that the list contained unusually old children still waiting for adoption. It was surprising for Chris and Lena to see children aged 5 to 11 years old on that list. Usually, couples prefer to adopt up to 3 years old. After 3 years, it's pretty hard for orphanages to convince couples to adopt their children, so children aged 5 and up were even more difficult to be adopted. After that age, most orphans were either adopted or started living independently with other abandoned children in Brazil. Chris found a link to another Brazilian website during the search, and he found something even more shocking. He read it many times as it wasn't in his language. On that site, he found all the unedited photos of those older children waiting for adoption. The site was Brazilian, but the photos didn't need any language to recognize the creepy participants. And then, Chris found Maria in those photos, and it was something that he didn't expect at all. Looking at those unedited photos, they realized that they trusted the wrong agency for adopting their child. The children in those photos looked physically young, but actually they weren't. Looking at their unedited faces, you realize they're not children, but adults, and Maria was one of those adult children. The site wrote down the actual ages of those children, and those were shocking for the couple. Learning about Maria's actual age made them skip a beat. They couldn't believe Maria's age was written in that big print. It was unbelievable for the couple. Maria wasn't a 6-year-old. She was a grown-up 32-year-old lady. It was absolutely shocking for Chris and Lena to know the girl sleeping in their home was not a little girl. They were deceived, and they discovered it. How is it possible? The fact shocked Chris and Lena, and they were not going to admit it. Lena quickly ran over and brought the documents handed over to them by that gray-haired lady at the airport. The medical reports inside the document confirmed her age. Maria was a 32-year-old grown woman with dwarfism. Hugging her, Linnea already suspected her body to have curves like that of a grown-up woman, and now it had been confirmed by her medical documents. They ran upstairs to verify the information. What they found inside Maria's room stoned them out of shock. Maria was putting up makeup on her face to look like a girl. She wasn't expecting the couple's abrupt entrance, and so she ended up shocked and scared. Chris and Lena were not going to believe the explanation Maria tried to give them about her age. At that time, she didn't know she'd been unmasked, and the couple had already read the documents confirming her age. When Maria realized they knew everything about her, she stopped dramatizing like a little girl. She shocked the couple once again when they tried to communicate in Portuguese and she replied in English. Chris and Lena were very disappointed since Maria ruined their dream of living together as a family. They thought their dreams were close to reality and that they would enjoy parenting and family life, but all of that vanished in the wink of an eye. Maria apologized for what she'd done to them and admitted that she cheated them with her physical appearance. She told them she wanted to come to America for a better life, and she used an orphan agency to fulfill her wish. The agency used her physical appearance to deceive couples for adoption. She told them how the agency helped her with his migration. They developed a website and marketed it on the internet, prepared the adoption papers from lawyers, and sped up the adoption process from months to 3 weeks. The agency did the same procedure with many other Brazilian dwarves. They misused the orphan system and abused the couple's sympathy with orphans. When the dwarves reached America, they left their new families to enjoy their new lives. All that information distressed the couple and ruined their dreams of having a family, but they decided to take this tragedy up to its climax. They didn't want anyone else to be deceived by such criminals. They took Maria to the police, where she told her story and helped the police arrest all those involved in the crime. As a reward, Maria was allowed to live her life as a new American citizen. Chris and Lena decided not to give up their family dream, but this time they decided to adopt a child from their own country, obviously after thorough verification. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and consider sharing it with someone who may find it interesting. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.